Greetings, minions! I am your humble narrator, Uncle Sideways, and I'm just here with a bit of an old brand new Let's Play an amount of, on that there PC, this time it's of Prison Architect. Yes, for those of you who do not know of Prison Architect, perhaps you've never heard of it, or perhaps you have heard of it, but don't quite know what it is, I'll give you a quick explanation as I start the very groundwork of my prison here. Prison Architect is, as the name implies, a game in which you build a prison. As the name does not imply, however, it is also a game in which you manage that, and you manage said prison. In fact, it's I think it's fairly accurate to say that you spend a lot more time managing said prison than you do actually building the fucking thing, which always, to me, made the name not quite make sense, but, well, I suppose that's, these things happen, don't they? But yeah, so you may notice I've just started talking immediately, I started working on shit immediately. Very simple reason for that. The very simple reason for that being that it occurred to me I've been wanting to do this series, and I've tried to do this series about 4 times now. Over the last few days, I tried to get this first episode because I realized that this game, I don't really have much to say while playing this game until I've actually got my prison at least somewhat built. So this like peculiarly lengthy period of time where we're just kind of waiting for the prison to finish being built is it's a bit awkward. Do you know what I mean? It's a bit awkward. It takes a while for us to get anywhere that's worth talking about. So yeah, I just wanted to start getting this out of the way. In fact, it may very well take so long that what I'm actually gonna do is I'm going to actually start this first episode. This isn't going to be a consistent thing in all the episodes, but, you know, while I'm currently in the process of just trying to get something built, I'm actually going to randomly talk about the other games I've been playing recently. More specifically, the fact that I've recently been playing a lot of Metal Gear Solid V The Phantom Pain. It's kind of made me wish that I'd played Metal Gear Solid V Ground Zeroes, because it's quite clear that, you know, the events of Metal Gear Solid V Ground Zeroes are actually fairly important to understanding what the fuck is going on in Metal Gear Solid V The Phantom Pain, but I recall distinctly at the time being of the opinion that I am not going to buy, you know, like, a full-price mini version of a game that is going to come out later, because, I don't know, maybe you'll disagree with me, but to my mind, that way lies madness. Like, that's the way that you lose your goddamn mind. But, and in fact, I didn't even buy The Phantom Pain. Some of you may know this, some of you may think I'm an idiot for what I'm about to tell you, but I, ladies and gentlemen, yes, I am, I'm subscribed to, would subscribe to be the correct term? I think so. But I have a PlayStation Plus subscription. Indeed, I go so far as to pay for it annually, because, well, it's just genuinely really good service. This sounds so much like I'm being paid by Sony, but I just actually quite genuinely do think that PlayStation Plus is actually just quite a good service. And though it does have this habit of you can go for lengthy periods of time, you can go for a couple of months before you get a game in your free games that's interesting to you, because especially if you're like me, in which case most of the big releases of the last few years don't particularly appeal, because PlayStation Plus has a habit of it'll give you a couple of games no one cares about, like indie games, and then it will give you a big name game. Not a recent one, but a big name game nonetheless. Let's get some electricity flowing through this place here, I think. But yeah, you'll get a big name game as well. It just kind of want, and some of the things take a while before, you know, whatever that big name game happens to be that month is one that interests you, but this month, the month of October, it was MGS5, The Phantom Pain, and I was pretty fucking down for that, because I kind of like Metal Gear Solid. I've got a peculiar relationship with that series, that Yeah, like, I kind of like it. Like, that's honestly as far as I can reasonably go in discussing my opinion of the Metal Gear Solid games. Is I kind of like them. I've played most of them. I've enjoyed most of them. I've completed most of them. But I'm not, as it were, I'm not a, you know, I'm not a fucking hashtag Metal Gear Solid fan TM. You know what I mean? I'm not... Not like really into it. It's just something I'm fairly fond of. Okay, so now we've actually built some stuff. But yeah, no, MGS5, the Phantom Pain. Having a really good time. Not happy about the fact that it's Kiefer Sutherland and not David Hayter. But, well, such is life. Right, now we actually need to get down to building things in the actual prison. Now we've got the basic shell. So what we're going to do is, going to tell you this, ladies and gentlemen. The existence of this quick build, I had no idea that this quick build thing existed for quite some time. I was... oh, so happy when I found out about the existence of the quick build. Like, of just the capacity to literally just hit a button, and then the game just like, yeah, totes, yeah, man, that's fine, that's great. That's fantastic, the existence of this quick build thing. Also occurs to me that, should probably get on selling all these random fuck-off logs here. No, not sell the light, I don't want to sell the light, let there be light. Just because I'm running a prison doesn't mean that I want to have everyone sat in the dark. I mean, granted, the reason I play this game is quite literally because I want to have and take advantage of and abuse having a large amount of control of over the lives of other human beings, regardless of whether or not those human beings were dicks. Fuck, this could be going to Guantanamo. Actually, no, because Guantanamo Bay. I'm not going to make a joke about Guantanamo Bay because that's a huge political pile of bullshit that I don't want to try and make funny right now. Because I do not know enough about that situation. I'm making jokes about that. So, let's not talk... Greetings, minions. I'm your humble narrator, Uncle Sideways, and I'm just here with another episode of Let's Not Accidentally Start Talking About Guantanamo Bay. Jumping fucking Jesus. Okay. Fuck. Can I go through, like... Can I get 2 weeks without putting my fucking foot in my mouth? Please. Please. I'm begging you. I'm begging you here. Begging you. There you go. Pipes. Okay, it just occurred to me that I just made that weird noise that, I'm not actually sure how many people are going to understand why I just went, pipes. Like, it's probably, yeah, because the YouTube channel I was referencing there is a, pretty unimportant one. And yeah, actually, let's quickly just dismantle that light, which is, yeah, somehow ended up inside the wall. Forgive me, but that doesn't seem like that can be all that important. Know what I mean? Hey, it's not, that doesn't strike me as where you want to be putting a light inside of a wall. Also, can we please actually pave this shit? I tell you guys, pave over this area, and just like, yeah, sure, but, do you want us to pave over the, do you want us to pave over the tree stump? And it's like, yeah, I want you to pave over the tree stump, you fucking worky piece of shit. Right. What else do we need to build here? Holding cell. Shower. Can't quick build those, can we? No, we cannot. Ah, well. Quickly just build some fucking piece of shit room where... There we go, just two nice little enclosed areas. That, you know, I'll even be really nice. So when they're in their little holding cell. There you go. You can see outside. Granted, the outside you can see is quite literally just like where the yard is going to be, but you know, you get to see it. Like, would you rather you got to see it or rather you didn't get to see it? It's up to you, really. That's not up to you, because I'm the one who's decided that I've put the fucking thing there, and I'm not getting rid of that for some poxy prisoner. Yeah. Because I, don't honestly care that much about the well-being of my prisoners. I care about the amount of money I'm going to make. That's my big concern. Am I going to be rolling in the cashola by the end of this system. Survey says probably not. Based on my past experience with this game, probably not. Probably not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then, and just put a nice big section of drains in the center there as well. All seems well and good. All seems nice and fair. And then we can just there we go, fantastic. And then we'll have built both the shower and the holding cell fully. And all will be well. Although, actually, it seems that the game's just accepting these as being built, even though I haven't finished the fucking thing. So, you know what? Yeah, no, fair enough. No, I'll accept that one, yeah. Ah, let's just get me some more perimeter fencing in there. Let's get myself. I mean, that perimeter fencing is definitely gonna come to bite me in the arse when it comes to, building to the other side of here, because I'm gonna have to go around the frigging perimeter fencing, but ah well, such is life, all is well. Now we just wait for the 3 days it's gonna take them, so we'll put down skadoo skadoo, two guards, and skadoo gadoo, two cooks. So that the guards and cooks can be there guarding no one and cooking for nothing, and cooking nothing. Fantastic. And actually, let's, quickly pave that in stone so it looks different from everything else. There we go. Have a nice kind of cobblestone effect on the yard. We can, put some weights in there. That's what prisoners do, isn't it? They lift weights. I think that's what they do. Dunno, try not to associate with criminals. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Probably a bit much to be spending on telephones, but these people have families they need to call. And I know for a fact that later on down the line I can put wiretapping in. So I'm gonna know everything that they talk about, so it'll be fantastic. There, make sure that that area is nice and lit so I understand what's going on in my prison. Don't want people fucking with me, do I? Okay, so I can't filter capacity because I don't have any capacity. That is fantastic. So I think what we'll actually do is, well, let's get the administration center built. I'm worried we're going to actually get through the entire first episode and have absolutely nothing to show for it in terms of prisoner population. Yeah, that's what this is sounding like. Okay, let's get myself let's get an office built here. Okay, let's get some offices built. Plop down a lovely little wardening bureaucracy there. Fantastic. Pick this specific warden for the simple reason that this one makes money off of contraband, which, well, it's sketchy as fuck, I'm not gonna lie. Like, that is by definite. In fact, it's very heavily implied that this particular woman is sketchy as fuck, but, I want that money. Simple truth. Not gonna lie, I want that money. I want that cash, yo. Let's actually also see if we can't build some cells here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6. Oh, I think that's actually 7 full cells. We can literally just plonk in there. This did kind of end up being fairly representative of the way I played this game. Was, well, this guy's going to be making a lot of escape attempts, I can tell you that. That's just what happens, Henta. Actually make sure that these people have some fucking lights, I'm thinking. Seeing as it's looking like, looking a little bit like none of those were getting lights, and this and that apparently is not a cell. Okay, there we go. Wondering whether or not that was going to flag up as a cell. Christ on a fucking bike. Ah, oh, cool, we can hire an accountant. Fantastic. Get in there, do accounting. And now we can actually, start making, taking in prisoners. Let's go intake, let's fill to capacity. Fantastic, we've got 17 hours before we need to worry about anything. I'm going to tell you right now, we're going to get some of this maintenance, we're going to get some of this security. Both very important things. Maintenance is, okay, they sound mental, and I actually realize what I'm about to say out loud, but maintenance, to me, is marginally more important. So, spread that out there. Also, actually put a thing up there as well. Get two larger sections built up here. Larger, because I'm gonna need to split this into two things later on, like a cleaning cupboard. One I've got once I've got the maintenance unlocked. To make this an actual functioning prison, you know, that can, you know, clean itself. As opposed to just being a filth-encrusted pile of crap. Pile of crap and villainy. And you know what, if I was going to name this prison, I think I might call it a pile of crap and villainy. Just like that's its official prison name. The pile of crap and villainy. I mean, it's a fairly accurate name for the kind of prison I'm going to be running. Which, in case you were wondering, is a pretty crap prison. A pretty crap prison indeed. Just dismantle that, put ourselves a staff door down. Because, let's be blunt here, prisoners don't need to be going back here. Prisoners don't need to be going back there. Why the hell would a prisoner need to go back there? No need. Absolutely no need. No need whatsoever for a prisoner to ever go back there. Silently. Okay, well, something's clearly gone wrong here. So I fucked it up. It's this man. We gotta dump the door. We couldn't just. That's just deeply upsetting. I don't know about you. You know, it has just occurred to me that the game is claiming that I've managed to actually get to the level it wanted, but I don't think I did. For the simple reason that none of these cells have plumbing yet, and personally, I don't think you should be allowed to put these people in here without plumbing. I mean, I'm gonna treat them like fucking animals, but that doesn't mean that they don't get to have a nice shit every once in a while. What am I, inhumane? I'm not inhumane, I'm an entirely goodly and decent man. Okay, granted, they asked for a prison that can hold 15, and, what they've got is a prison that can hold 20, 21, and two guards for... 21 gu- okay, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Just gonna have 10 of those guys in security chief down there. Because I've realized exactly what it is. What it is that I've got myself in for here, that I've got a lot of... The fucking... Bill, give that man a... Give that man a turlet, like... Sorry, I can't remember where... Can't remember where I heard the term turlet, but I know I've heard the word, the term turlet somewhere before. Where is the fucking office? There's the fucking office. Give this bro again. Get me another fucking office in here. Can we get another fucking office in here? We need another fucking office in here. I mean, that's fantastic. So can we get a foreman in here? Excellent. And now let's get some cleaning, groundskeeping, deployment, and patrols done. There is a lot of research that we clearly needed to do, but did not do before we started this whole prison malarkey. A lot of shit that needed to get done, which just didn't get done. Personally, I say blame the government. Always blame the government. Never on my end, blame the government. Ah, oh, this is just, that's shameful. They just left a cabbage on the floor. Fuck, I could get sued. That cat, like, the fucking cabbage lobby is a very powerful lobby, and they do not want these things being left on the floor. Not in the slightest. Prison policy. No. Health. Let's go for health. Don't know why I pronounced that like that. Ah, oh, well, such is life. We don't really need to research anything more right now. Enjoying your yard time, lads. Enjoying from, like, being able to be outside for a couple of sec- What are my guards doing? Oh my god, my god. Yeah, deployment. Okay, good. Can we- 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm sorry, but you assholes, we've got a prison full of people, and it didn't occur to any of you guys to maybe spend some time in the cell block. You just thought you were gonna hang out in the yard, did you? Just thought that you know, work doesn't apply to you. 1, 2, 3. Janitors in there. Some janitors in there. Let's also get some cleaning cupboard. It's very big for a cleaning cupboard, but we'll sort that. I'll be explained down the line. Let's also actually quickly make ourselves a lovely little little staff room over here. Nice little staff room, you know, for the staff to live in. Now, where do you keep your staff? Working? Nah, mate. Staff don't work. Staff rest, staff recuperate. Where's the pissing staff room option? Where are you, friend? Staff room. Lovely. Let's get some 1, 2, 3, 4 wide sofas. Let's get 3 drinks machines in there. Bit of a radio. Get some TVs in there. And we're getting the weird bug where this is just going to complain that no one's set to eat at this canteen, even though it's not a canteen, but we'll worry about that later. That's a bug that's just never been fixed. It's fine, don't worry about it. It does actually occur to me that I could make this a separate area if I sealed that off. Yeah, what, actually? Where the fuck's that doll? Actually, gonna... Yeah, I'm actually gonna make that a separate deployment area. There we go. That way we have one guy who's always patrolling this area, another guy who's always patrolling this one. Patrolling. Christ. It's like my face is made of cheese or something. Do not question why I just said it's like my face is made of cheese. There is no rational explanation for you there. That, trying to figure out why I just said that, let me tell you, friend, that way lies madness. There is nothing. You gain nothing by trying to figure out what the fuck I think I'm talking about. You gain nothing from that. Okay, well, I'm thinking we'll just get this room finished and then... Cool. Now that's done, I think what we're actually going to do here, ladies and gentlemen, is, we're going to actually call this an episode. Yeah, we're going to call the episode that. Because, in the next episode, we're going to get down to actually, we're going to actually start worrying about actually running the prison. We just got our basic building blocks down now. Basic building blocks to the Hive of Scum and Villainy. I don't know if there is a way for me to specifically name the prison. I don't think that ever really comes up. But, yeah, we'll start. We've built the basics of this Hive of Scum and Villainy, and we're going to worry about maintaining this Hive of Scum and Villainy in the future. But that's going to be all for me for now. I've been your humble narrator, Uncle Sideways, and, well, bye. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching this video as much as I enjoyed making it. Right, let's cut the crap to this end slate, doesn't take forever. I want to thank these lovely minions, whose names are on the screen right now, for donating to my Patreon campaign to help keep the channel going. If you want to donate as well and get your name on this list and the one in the description, you can follow the link in the description to my Patreon page and pledge some money there, it would be appreciated. Down there you will also find a link to my Twitter, where I post random bullshit, ranty bullshit, and indeed every single video I put up, because Lord knows you can't trust YouTube to do it for you anymore. Right, we done? Is it over?
It's over!